Recently, I've been learning some JavaScript, and something that I wanted to build was a small React project. Now, I knew at some point I would need to reach for some sort of module bundler to do the building and the bundling for me, and my first instinct was to just take Webpack and use it in development. You know, that's something I used at work, and that just seems to be the most popular one out there. And I did a little bit of digging, and after some research, I realized that there's a lot of other tools that we could use, and there was one in particular that caught my eye. Hi, my name is Jonathan. Today, I want to go through and talk about Snowpack. So what is Snowpack? Snowpack is a node module bundler created by Fred K. Scott, and version 3 of Snowpack was released last month on January 13. Now, it's specifically targeted for developer experience. So what does it actually mean? Well, I kind of need to talk about module bundlers and why they exist in the first place. As applications have grown and grown, we've had to find ways to manage all the various JavaScript, CSS, image files that we have and bring them onto our web page. Now, it'd be a nightmare to try and manage each of these dependencies manually, like importing the script directly to the website and then figuring out the ordering of everything. But that's where module bundlers come in. They take all of these files, they build them, like bring them together, build them, run some sort of processing on them, and then output and optimize production ready file. Now this file is like minified, so it's small, any unused code is removed, and that is amazing for production. But what about development? Because when you have one of these module bundlers, they're gonna do the same actions in development. And sure, there might be some configurations it can do, but ultimately it's still gonna bundle everything and output a single file. And that's the beauty of Snowpack. It doesn't need to do this. Snowpack actually builds each of these files once and then caches them indefinitely, or at least until they change. So instead of bundling everything, it builds everything once, and then whenever you make a change, it will just rebuild that one file. So you can imagine if you have a lot of JavaScript files or a lot of just files in general, and you make a small change, a modular bundler will have to go through, aggregate all of these files, run some processing, and then output something at the end. But with Snowpack, that one file change, it will just rebuild that one file. So that's really, really fast. So how does all of this work? Well, Snowpack leverages ECMAScript modules, ESM, or JavaScript modules, to import code directly into the browser. And that's really just using those import-export statements that you may have seen elsewhere. I think React uses import-export statements. And because of the advent of like modern browsers and because they can handle this, Snowpack is able to leverage this feature and just take all of your JavaScript files and directly put them into your browser without you needing to handle any of the management or like ordering internally. You can just trust Snowpack will do it for you. And the cool advantage of this is now that you have a JavaScript file that's imported separately, well, it's really easy to go and see that file. You can go in and change that file and you don't need to worry about, okay, this is now like minified or this is bundled. Oh, and I need to find the source map. No, with Snowpack, you can just directly import stuff to the browser, which is really cool. And there's a bunch of other really fun features with Snowpack. So it has inbuilt hot module replacement for CSS, CSS modules, and JSON. So if you make a change to one of those files, your browser will automatically update to show that change without you needing to refresh. And it also has, you know, the ability to include fast refresh through plugins, and there are a lot of plugins with Snowpack. And with fast refresh, you can make changes to a component, say in React, and instead of having to refresh your page and lose the state, well, your page will update for you and you don't need to worry about losing state. But eventually, we'll need to push this to production. And Snowpack isn't great for that. It's, again, for development. It's no bundling for development. And this doesn't really make sense in production. So with, again, through plugins, you can actually use Webpack or Rollup or any other module bundler you want to do that building for you. So in other words, Snowpack is saying that module bundling is opt-in. And finally, Snowpack has some really fun experimental features. In version 3, they released this idea of streaming imports and also using ESBuild as your module bundler. So again, this is kind of on the cutting edge of things. ESBuild is not production ready yet, but it's super fast when it comes to bundling, and it's starting to get that feature parity to Webpack and Rollup and all of that stuff. And with streaming imports, well, let me just show you what that looks like. Okay, so I want to show you this Hello World Snowpack app that demonstrates streaming imports. So in my package.json, all I'm importing in, or all my dependency is just, it's just Snowpack. I also have a start and a build script that runs the Snowpack dev server and the Snowpack build command. And then in my Snowpack config, I have source remote turned on. Now, this is really important because streaming imports is an opt-in feature. And then some other kind of app-related stuff. I have a app component that's literally just Hello World. And then that's pulled in via the index.js file. And the interesting thing here is import React from React and import React from React DOM is actually being pulled via CDN. So let's just see how all of this works. So I'm gonna install everything. If I can type, that'd be great. Okay, it added 18 packages, so it didn't add a crazy amount of stuff. Like, you know, if I pulled in React or React DOM, it'd be pretty insane. And I can npm run start, and then this will run my Hello World app. Also have a pink background on my body. So what's interesting to note here is import React latest and import React DOM is being pulled in via the CDN. So what is the CDN? It actually points to Skypack. So Skypack kind of has your npm packages, but they're optimized, so they're pre-built and pre-bundled to run efficiently on your application. And the other thing to note is because they're being pulled in from a URL, it's always going to be pulling in latest. You can pin a version number if you want, but for prototyping, which is what I'm doing right now, latest is totally fine for me. And it also caches the projects or the bundles, I should say, in the React in the .snowpack folder right here. So what happens if we want to import something else? Well, it's pretty easy. We can have a look at this thing here, import confetti. If I can type again, confetti from canvas confetti. And with streaming imports, we don't need this like URL right here. And then we can just call confetti. I'm gonna switch over to this site. And when I save this, it reruns and shoots some confetti. And that's a cool another feature that Snowpack has out of the box. It has hot module reloads. So if I want to change my background to be blue in CSS, it does it automatically. If I want to change red, you know, it does it automatically. And that is a terrible color, so I'm going to back to pink. So yeah, everything reloads really fast. It's really easy to prototype, and streaming imports are fantastic. So should you use Snowpack? Well, there are definitely Snowpack alternatives out there. Evan Yu, who created Vue, has also created a new module bundler called Vite or Vite. And that is like something similar to Snowpack, has kind of the same features. It does use rollup as your module bundler. So when you're building for production, it uses rollup. And it's an awesome technology, but Snowpack kind of gives you that flexibility to pick and choose which one you want. And then I also haven't used Snowpack in production or at large scale. So I don't know what that configurability is like. There's definitely ways you can configure your Snowpack build. There's a Snowpack config that you can go in and play around with. But again, I don't know what that looks like. If you're interested in seeing Snowpack in action, I have ideas of making a little Snowpack tutorial where I build a Svelte or React app with Snowpack and Supabase. If that's interesting to you, please let me know in the comments below. Otherwise, if you like this video or if you want to stay tuned for more, please hit that like button, hit that subscribe, all the YouTube things, and I'll see you next time. Bye.